Hello again, guys. This is Pointman, here to give you a commentary on this deploying to the war online battle number 14. I play as Ottomans. My opponent, Bnbader, plays as Britain. And here's my opponent's army. He has 2 riflemen, 1 blackwash, 2 riflemen right here, 4 riflemen total, 188 foot, that's an Imperial Edition unit, 2 lifeguards right here, 1 general, 4 foot guards, and 2 more lifeguards on this flank, so that's a total of 4 lifeguards of his. And that's the only cavalry he brought. And I brought my basic army, as always. But against Britain, I kind of wanted to bring in an extra unit of rifles. Well, I saw a chance to attack his unit since they were still repositioning, and riflemen are very fast now and have a lot of stamina, so they run way ahead of your line, so you gotta keep watch of that. Because this is the little mistake he made early on to match. He lost a unit this early into the match, so you really don't want to lose this kind of unit. And the price difference of these units is amazing. That's what most people do in StarCraft. However amount of units they kill, they always give you the price difference of how much money they lost, how much they gained, how much they saved by killing a certain unit and saving a certain unit. So all in all, it goes the same with Napoleon Total War also, so he's losing a big price difference between this one little cav unit. So I destroyed one of his riflemen that are about equal in funds as that one cavalry unit of mine. So I depleted one of his and I killed another one. So he's going to push up with his foot guards, and since he has his cavalry chasing this one unit of mine, I'm just going to run him away so he'll get all his cavalry away from that flank, because that's where my Janissaries are and they can't form square formation, so I know they're screwed if he decides to go for a cavalry charge. And over here I saw his 2 lone lifeguard units trying to walk away, so I wanted to lure them in melee, and I saw that he was repositioning one of his troops, so I tried to run my guys away and shoot them from the side with mine. I could have pushed up with my infantry to shoot him from the back or from the sides, but I saw that he still had 3 foot guards moving up, so I didn't want to reposition yet. Right now I was really focused on killing the rest of his cav, and there was a chance to do that just now. Oh, on this flank I was starting to lose, so I pulled back a little. Well, here's his foot guards. They're gonna start like a little skirmish with my rifles. But over here, I could have went into a cav fight with him, but not until I was sure that my infantry was near enough to actually use some to do some supporting fire, so I'll definitely win that fight. And he apparently knew that he was going to lose that fight also, so he retreated back uphill. So now, after he was doing repositioning, getting a little bit organized, he was going to start the skirmish fights with me again. And since he has that little hill advantage, he's going to get an extra little range boost to his riflemen, so I have to move up. And I'm going to start moving my cav behind his lines. So pretty much he's making a little defensive position on this little hill on this map. So this has turned into a mini siege for me. So I had to harass his defenses and exploit some weaknesses. And right now I have the rifle superiority. I have 1 more than him, since I killed one of his so early into the match. So I'm just doing some harassment attacks, weaken his infantry and all. Because as I'm doing that, he's focusing all 3 of his foot guards on one unit, so that gives me time to position the rest of my units without taking any early damage. So right now I'm dealing some flanking fire to this unit of foot guard. And I saw a chance to attack his lone riflemen right there. They're very depleted, so I just wanted to break them easily. And he's going to give off some accurate shots with his 88 foot. They're going to keep repositioning until they shoot my guards, or my cav. And look at this on this flank. He sent his depleted unit of his general staff and one of his lifeguards to attack one of my cav. And I lured him into a little trap here. He must not have been managing his unit well, because look at this little... He just marched right into an alleyway of my cav. Well, I'm going to push up on this flank. I saw some lone riflemen that were unprotected. Well, here's this little trap I set for my opponent. I'm gonna start surrounding him with cav, and I killed his general real quick because they had only 4 units in his general staff left, so it was very easy to kill the rest of his general staff. And he lost a unit of lifeguard, and that kind of pissed him off, so he sent the rest of his lifeguards to that flank, I guess to get some revenge. Over here I'm gonna take some flanking fire on his foot guards, or his 88 foot, I mean. Here's his Black Watch, he's gonna send him into melee against my cav. Well, I'm gonna start doing some flanking maneuvers again with my cav, hit him from behind. But instead of attacking one unit at a time with his cav, he's gonna attack him individually, which is actually smarter to do. So right here I'm gonna do a little flanking attack, and I'm gonna send up a supporting unit of credit infantry. But before they even gave off any shots yet, I already routed his lifeguards. So that just shows you that the lance is better than a saber now in this game. It really does show you that, because lifeguards in Empire Total War was much more superior than most cavalry, because they were counted as heavy cavalry in that game. So right now in this game, they're counted as light cavalry to me, since they're so easily defeated by lancers. So he got into a little melee fight with my Janissaries, and he routed them. But as he was fighting my units, they were taking some free shots from my second unit of Janissaries. So I'm attacking his last foot guards on that little hill. Well, I'm going to send up my credit infantry that helped support me in that little cav fight. And as you can see, I won that little fight. Here's what's left of it. So with only 3 units of my lancers, I was able to kill 3 lifeguards and 1 depleted unit of general staff. So I'm going to send the rest of my cav to attack these depleted units. And there he goes, one of his foot guards there. And I'm going to send a unit right behind him also to shoot from the back. And this is his last unit. And I'm just going to send my cav to finish him off. Attack routing units. After the match, my opponent said that I did well, and I told him he did well also. So this was a good game, and I enjoyed it entirely with my opponent.